Hello, namaskar, satriyakaal and salam to everyone. Welcome to Captain Classes. And today I'm going to teach you about the urgency and distress messages. So today the both kind of messages I'll be discussing. So first I would like to tell you, and in this video I'll be discussing about the topics, distress messages, the format, and with the example, including the urgency messages format with example. So please watch this video till the end to get the more and more and a better understanding of both the distress messages and the urgency messages. So first of all, I would like to tell you what are the distress messages. So distress messages, that means that grave and imminent danger threatens and require immediate assistance by ATC. So in that case, we use mayday, mayday in the prefix. We use a mayday, mayday, and in the other, which is the urgency case, in which the aircraft is having a very important message concerning about the safety of any ship, an aircraft, vehicle, or anything. It means a person on board, a person within sight, so that may compel to land the aircraft. In that case, but not requiring immediate assistance. So in that case, we use. We can say that messages are urgency messages. So in urgency messages, we use pan, and the priority is given to the distress messages over the pan message, or you can say just urgency messages. So you can see on the board, I have written both the formats for the pan and distress messages, and the both the formats are almost same, as there is a slight difference, only one or two differences are there, otherwise the each and every point is almost same. So first we will discuss about the pan, or you can say urgency messages. So in this, you can see, first of all, we are saying pan, three times. So no need to read or no need to write pan, you can write this way also. This is also correct. Then station called will be the same. Station calling, your call sign, on frequency, the ATC unit to whom you are calling, that frequency you have to put. Then condition, you have to mention the condition, which condition you are having, or what kind of situation you are going through. So you have to tell the condition of that message. Then position. Position should be given in the terms of DME, nautical mile, position, reporting point, time, flight level, route, same. And then the intention. So what you have to do is, you have to tell the condition, then position, and then intention. So you can see CPI, we used to say CPI condition, you have to follow the CPI format, C, P and I format, condition, position and intention format, in which you are telling the condition first, position then, and then the intention. Your intention could be request firefighting services for something, or request, if you have seen some kind of train accident, so you can say request firefighting and medical emergencies on the spot. So the intention can be anything, or you can request for landing also. So in that case, the intention can be anything. And in mayday condition, which require immediate assistance, you know. So now the mayday condition, you can see almost the format is almost same. There is a slight difference. So first of all, we'll see the first point, which is mayday, mayday, mayday three times, and station called, station calling, on frequency, everything is same. Condition, you have to tell the condition, same like in pan also we were telling the condition, what condition we are actually going through, and this I'll tell you about afterwards. Then intention, what is your intention? So in this case, we are giving the intention first, means we are giving condition, then we are giving intention first, not giving the position. So we are giving the intention first because we require immediate assistance. So we are focusing on the condition and then the intention. So that's why we have to give intention first and then position. So position will remain same, the way the position we give, it's same. The format, you can see it is having CIP. So this is the only difference in mayday and pan, you can say the CIP. In mayday it is CIP, and pan it is CPI, which is a normal thing. CPI is a very normal format, or you can say normal sequence in every kind of, whether it is a pan or any small condition in which, suppose for example, we have discussed RVSM, weather deviation. In each and every condition, we have used the CPI format only. First, we have tell that what condition it is. Suppose if it is RVSM, then we have said unable RVSM due equipment, which is a condition. Then we have given the position, whatever the position we are. And then we requested the intention. Then we requested for some flight level, lower flight level, or some deviation. So that CPI format is very common. You can say we are using CPI in each and every format, kind of format in which any kind of condition is there. But CIP is only and only for mayday condition. So in this case, we have to tell the intention first, then position. So I have written intention. On intention, I have written will commence emergency landing at nearest aerodrome. So this is the most common, or you can say it is obvious for any mayday condition. Mayday, that means you are about to die in it, it's a such kind of condition. So in that case, we have to commence emergency landing at nearest aerodrome, whatever it is. Don't say will commence emergency landing at nearest aerodrome. I've written the nearest aerodrome in a bracket. That means you have to tell the ATC which is the nearest aerodrome from your position. So you'll say the name of that aerodrome. For example, if it is Jaipur, so you have to say will commence emergency landing at Jaipur. So this is how it is, and you can see the format, and let's just have a look on both the formats and we'll see what are the differences. So first difference is this, the PAN-PAN, we are using PAN-PAN, and in this mayday, station calling, on frequency, condition, yes, position we are giving here, in this position we are giving here, at the 7th point, we are giving here in the, at the 6th point, and the 7th, 8th is the intention here, 6th is the intention. So if we combine these two points, these two points is always come along with each other. So you can say these have been shuffled. So the position has gone down in this case, and in this case position is after condition. So this is how mayday and PAN-PAN we have. And let's talk about the example. We'll take the example and then see what we can do, or what we say exactly in case of mayday and PAN-PAN. There's one more point, in additional point you can say in mayday format, which I forgot. So I added in this format. So you can see in the 9th point, we have to give person on board, POB, heading of the aircraft, and fuel on board. So these are the additional information which you can say it deserves in very informative thing. So in that case, if you want to suppose in case when the aircraft has been crashed, so there is no communication, means if aircraft is in mayday or it has been crashed somewhere, so in that case there will be no communication. So we while giving this information, so the captain has, if the captain has informed, then what how many person on boards were there, and what is the heading of the aircraft, and what was the fuel on board. So we can estimate that how many bodies, or you can say how many human bodies are there, or you can have you recovered all the bodies or not. So there will be an idea of this thing, heading. So after getting the heading of the aircraft, you can at least make out where the aircraft is going towards, and with the help of fuel on board, you can also think, you can decide the search area to on depend on the fuel on board. So you can calculate the aircraft can move or have traveled how much distance according to the fuel on board and the heading. So you can find out the direction in which you have to rescue, or you have to instigate, or you can say start your search and rescue operation. So here I've written the flight plan and the conditions, one for PAN-PAN, one for mayday, and all the informations are there. You can see the chart number is 5 for the example. You can say for this example, this is chart number 5 I'm referring, and Delhi to Hyderabad, the flight is going. I fly 9R68 is the flight number. 2120 is the estimated scheduled departure. Route is Whiskey 20 South, Bravo Papa Lima and Whiskey 20. Flight level 310 and 320. So that means I have given two flight levels. That means somewhere the heading might change. So not might change, that gonna change, because that's why the two figures, or you can say two flight levels, are there. So let's find out on the map what is the exact route. So on this map, this is the chart number 5 from Delhi to Hyderabad. Okay, so the route is Whiskey 20 South and it is going up to Bravo Papa Lima as given in the flight plan. It is not visible. It is Bravo Papa Lima and then Whiskey 20, and okay, Bravo Papa Lima and then Whiskey 20. It is this side and it is going up to Hyderabad. The condition says the first and both condition, the both the condition, the position is same, which is 25 nautical miles from both Bhopal. So first we'll find out where Bhopal is. So in this route, Buklo, okay, this is Bhopal. And Bhopal is having tower and approach tower. Okay, it has written approach, but there is no approach as far as given the mention in this map. So it is ground level to 145, and after 145 you can see Nagpur TMA is there. So after 150, Nagpur would be taking care of all the traffic. So my flight level must be, if I am following this route, so my flight level must be in easterly. That means I'll be flying in the odd flight level, and this is the route which I have to follow after Bhopal. So it is saying Bravo Whiskey 20, and we are 25 nautical miles from Bhopal. So this circle is 30 nautical miles. Somewhere here we'll be flying, and we experience some condition, whatever written in the question. So we'll be contacting in this area because my flight level is 310. So I'll be in this Nagpur TMS. So I'll contact Nagpur control. So Nagpur control's frequency is 123.9. So we'll contact accordingly. So you're 25 nautical miles from Bhopal and your co-pilot fainted, which is a pan-pan condition. If in case the pilot fainted, so in that case it is a mayday condition. So this is co-pilot condition, co-pilot fainted, so it is a mayday, not a mayday condition, it is a pan-pan condition. So we'll say pan-pan three times, station called. As we have seen the map, this Nagpur control, station calling will be your call sign. So this is I fly 9R68 on frequency we have seen, which is 12. Let me check out again. Condition, I know the condition, which is co-pilot fainted. So co-pilot fainted. Position remains same. Position, and here we have to give the position of the aircraft, which is 25 DME from Bhopal. We have to find out the VOR three-letter code for Bhopal, which is Bravo Papa Lima. You can see, or you can find out on your map also. So I'll say Bravo Papa Lima here, and flight level correction time is 2120 is the departure time. So I'll take around 1 hour. So it will be 2220 flight level. We have seen in the map, we are flying in the easterly heading, so odd level 310. And route currently we are following after Bhopal is, you can see, Whiskey 20. It is not visible here from here, but I think it will be seen that Whiskey 20 is the route. So Whiskey 20 intention is request landing at. You can request landing at Bhopal because Bhopal is the nearest aerodrome. So request landing at Bhopal. Once you get the clearance, then you have to give the position report, and you can say not the position report, you can say the ETA on the Bhopal you have to add. And in case ATC doesn't say go to the next question, you can you have to follow the question, follow up the question. In that case, once you get the clearance, you have to say, you have to give the ETA for Bravo Papa Lima. Okay, so in this case, in the second case, it is the media condition, and you can see here it is written you are 25 nautical miles from Bhopal, that you observed fire on engine number 1. So fire is the condition of mayday, or you can say there are so many conditions in which the mayday condition is declared. First is fire on engine, fire on boat, smoke, fire warning, any structural damage, that means suppose a bird strike is there, any kind of structural damage, everything is in mayday condition. Pilot fainted, your controls have been you control on the control surfaces have been lost, hydraulic pressure, or you can say hydraulic system is not working. In that case also the control surfaces cannot be moved and controlled. So, and these are the conditions in which you can say the mayday condition is supposed to be, or it is said to be in mayday condition. So I have taken one example, which is fire on engine number 1. So I'll solve this according to your fire on engine number 1. So first point will remain same, mayday. Station call is Nagpur control. Station calling is 6E, that means I fly 9068 on frequency, which we have seen from the map, which is 123 decimal 9. Condition is fire on engine number one. What is your intention? Intention is always same, will commence emergency landing at nearest aerodrome. So yeah, we have to say will commence emergency landing at, again Bhopal is the nearest one, so I'll say Bhopal. Position, position 25 DME from Bravo Papa Lima, 2220, flight level 310, whiskey 20. Now extra information, which are the person on board and all, and the additional information which we have to give in case of mayday, which is the very important part, you can say. So which is person on board, so I have taken the type of aircraft 320, so it is having around a capacity of 180 maximum. So I'll take 150, which obviously it is not possible to have full load, not every time. So I'll take it as 150, and heading is 170. If you see on the map, the route I'm following, in that map my heading will be 170. The fuel on board I have taken hypothetically is 1 ton. So this is how your mayday condition is. You have to follow this sequence only, no need to change the sequence. Means if you have shuffled these two points, then also this is wrong. If you have shuffled these two points, then also this is wrong. So please make sure you have to follow this sequence only. You don't have to change, or you don't have to do any kind of alteration, nothing. Fire on engine number 1, that's it. Fire catches on engine number 1, no, not required. Fire on engine number 1, if it is written on the cushion, fire catches on engine number 1 or something else, or explained in a very if it is explained very much. So in that case also you have to say fire on engine number one. That's it. No need to say each and every point from the question. Fire on engine number one is the perfect condition of phrase for RT exams. Okay. So this is how your mayday and pan condition is. And I hope this video is very informative in case if you are giving RTR exam, if you are planning to give RTR exam. And please watch my previous videos also, in which I have discussed each and every point of it, because most of the time people have skipped one or two videos. In that case, you will not be able to give the position why I am giving position like this. There is a video on which I have explained each and every point where I have to give position. So there is a topic, is the link will be in the description. You will find the link. And please watch my previous videos also in that case. So you will be having a better idea of RTR topics and exams. I have also discussed in the last video the tips and tricks, which is very important. One thing which I missed in the tips and tricks was the chart number. I forgot to tell you about the chart number, which is also very important things. Most of the time people start finding out the chart in which the destination and departure headroom is, but in the question paper itself it is given on the top which chart it is following. So that is not a big thing. You have to don't have to follow, or you don't have to find out the chart number. That is already given in the question paper. Sometimes it requires two charts, so that will be given in this thing, 5 or 6, 5 or 1, whatever the map they are using. So you don't have to find out the chart where the departure and destination both are given, or you don't have to find out for the route and all. The chart will be given on the top of your question paper. That's it. So this was missing in the tips and tricks video. And everything was already discussed in that video. So I hope those who are giving the exam will keep those things in mind, will help you a lot. And I will not say that's the only thing. You have to study a lot, you have to follow, and you have to do a mock. You have to take mock examples, and you have to follow each and every point, and you have to find out where you are lagging, where you are not following the format, which point is not you are not remembering in the format. So that work has to be, that homework has to be done by you. So I hope this video is good. If you like this video and you find this video is informative, please give a like, share with your friend who are from aviation background and who are giving or planning to give RTR exam. And please do subscribe my channel to get latest updates on whenever I'll put a video. You'll get the latest updates if you select the bell icon on the channel. Thank you so much. Good day. Have a nice day, and fly high.